Good evening, dear ladies. I would like to bless all of us, Bezat Hashem, that we will all have the school to greet Mashiach Tzidkenu Baruch Hu Mimoim Bimarav Yameinu Amen. Eliyahu Navi, Eliyahu Tishbi, Eliyahu Gilevi, Bimarav Mashiach David, Eliyahu Nagzachu Latov. And we all have the zechut to go to Eretz Yisrael on the wings of eagle. Amen. And Nesiyat HaDishma, may we all have part in Eretz Yisrael. And may we all see the building of Beit HaMikdash HaShlishi B'Mirah B'Yameinu Amen. Ki'ayin B'Yameinu Shubba Tzion. Ki'ayin B'Yameinu Yiru B'Shubba Adonai Tzion. And Nesiyat HaDishma, B'Shem HaShem Nasa V'Natzliach, En Od Milvado. And השיעור לעילוי נשמת רבי חיים יוסף בן דוד ברחל, עליו השלום תשמת רצור וצור החיים, לעילוי נשמת דוד בן אפרים, עליו השלום תשמת רצור וצור החיים, לעילוי נשמת חננאל מרדכי בן רחל, עליו השלום תשמת רצור וצור החיים, לעילוי נשמת יהודית פרל בת אורית, ולעילוי נשמת מלכה בת אברהם, ולעילוי נשמת מזל בת אסתר, עליה השלום תשמת רצור וצור וצור החיים. And for רפואה שלמה to כלל עמו ישראל, everybody that needs מאלף עד תף, בעזרת השם. אוקיי, בשם השם נעשה ונצליח, אין עוד מלבדו, השם שפתי תפתח וכפי הייתי לתת. Now, dear ladies, בסייעתא דשמיא, you know, it seems that it's short, or I became short, remember that? So, בסייעתא דשמיא, we're going to speak about that in the 3 weeks, we're going to speak about ירושלים. Why we need to daven to Hashem, to pray to Hashem, and ask for Beit HaMikdash Shibaneh B'mirah B'yameinu Amen. It says, B'siyata Dishmaya, in Zohar Chadash, Parashat Noach, it's written over there, B'siyata Dishmaya, Amar Rabbi Yehuda, Asa HaKadosh Baruch Hu Yerushalayim Lemala Kenegad Yerushalayim Shel Mata. Hashem built Yerushalayim that is in heaven, parallel to Yerushalayim that is in this world. That's why everybody is fighting for Yerushalayim. Because all of the souls came from the first human being. They all know in their subconscious how this place is so holy. It's the gate of the whole world. It's the place where the whole world was built. So everybody in their subconscious know that. So that's why everybody's fighting over Yerushalayim. So Hashem made the Yerushalayim in heaven parallel to Yerushalayim in this world. And then it's written, וְנִשְׁבָּה שֶׁלֹּא יָבוֹא שָׁם. And he promised that he's not going to go into Yerushalayim, Jerusalem, that is in heaven, עד שיבואו ישראל בירושלים של מטה. Until the children of Israel will be again in Yerushalayim and Beit HaMikdash will be built. Can you imagine? שנאמר בקרבך קדוש ולא אבוא בעיר. That it says that I will be among you and I'm not going into the city until בעזרת השם the children of Israel will be in Yerushalayim and Beit HaMikdash will be built. So let's continue. Where did the city of Yerushalayim, Jerusalem, get her name? Where does it come from? Everything starts with Bereshit. We went back to Bereshit, we're traveling. We're going to speak through the Likutei Shoshanim, B'siyata Dishmaya, Nitzotzei Shoshanim, Shimshon, Slicha, Shoshanim. Nitzotzei Shimshon, B'siyata Rabbi Shimshon, Nostropoli, Alav HaShalom, Sotot Hagen Alenu, Hashom Yikom Damo. Shabbanot Yekarot, and remind me that I will speak about, I'm just reminding you that this Shabbat is Shabbat Rosh Chodesh. It's one day of Rosh Chodesh, Rosh Chodesh Av. We are finishing Chumash Bamidbar. We are having two parashiyot, Matot u'Masei. So let's continue. We're going back to Parashat Toldot. And remember that Rivka, Yitzchak and Rivka, they couldn't bring children. They davened to Hashem, each one in a different side, parallel to each other, a different side of the room. Hashem opened her womb. She got pregnant with twins. They were fighting all the time in her womb. It hurt her so much. She went to ask in the name of Hashem. She went to ask, and what's happening? And Hashem tells her like this. Vayomer Hashem la. Hashem tells her, Shnei goyim bebitnech. You have two people, which means nations, in your belly. Two people, two nations are going to be separated from your womb. And once one of the nations becomes stronger, the other one is weaker. Then one becomes stronger, the other one is weaker. But eventually, the older will worship the young one, will be under the young one, which means Esav yeh tachat Yaakov. Esav will be under Yaakov Bezrat Hashem. Because two children, it's Yaakov Esav. So we continue in Besiyata Dishma. What does it mean? We'll come to it. This is the opening, just we'll come to it and understand. We see that Avraham Avinu, Hashem tells him, we jumped to Yitzchak, now we're going back to Avraham Avinu. Hashem tells him, now I'm going to give you a son, and from this son there will be the children of Israel, and they will be my firstborn, and I will give him the land of Israel, and I will give him the Torah. This is a promise from Hashem. Hashem is Ein Sofi, is unlimited, and his promises are also unlimited. It's forever. And he says to Avraham Avinu, once Yitzchak is born, he tells Avraham Avinu, go and sacrifice your son. And he takes his son to sacrifice him, and he goes 3 days, and he finds that mountain, and he goes to the mountain. He puts Yitzchak on the altar. He ties a leg and an arm, so because Yitzchak told him, I don't want to move, I want to be a pure sacrifice, that there won't be any defect. And he puts his throat, and Avraham Avinu takes the sword, and an angel comes and says, Avraham, stop, don't do that. I now know that you have the fear of Hashem, and now everybody knows. And Hashem shows him an ayil b'siyata d'shmeh that he takes instead and sacrifices him. And the Midrash says that Yitzchak Avinu went for 3 years to be healed in Gan Eden in this world, in paradise in this world. That's why when Yaakov comes in, he has two sons, the twins that we just spoke about them. When Yaakov comes in, he says, Reach bni kereach hasadeh sher berecho Hashem. The smell of my son is like the smell of the garden of Eden that Hashem blessed, because it was there for years, so he smelled. Why did Yaakov have? Because he had the smell of the Torah. That's why he had, the Torah has a smell of Gan Eden. That's why when Mashiach comes, which means he will know who is really true with Hashem, because the smell of the soul will be the smell of paradise. By the smell, he will know the difference between people who are really true with Hashem and people who are not true with Hashem. So no disguise will help us. We need our hearts clean. Okay, so he goes, and then this is what Avraham Avinu says. Vayikra Avraham Shem HaMakom, so he calls the mountain a name. Shem HaMakom Ahu Hashem Yireh, which means Hashem is going to see. Asher Yamer Hayom Behar Hashem Yireh. Spare this, and it's twice the word see, but it's the Nikud, the dots are different. Because the first one, this is how he's calling the name, that Hashem saw, mamash. And the second one, Hashem Yireh, it will become time that my children will receive the Torah and they will see Hashem. Lachen Yireh, on this mountain, because Hashem took Har HaMoriah and the mountain of Sinai, and they put one above the other and put it on the children of Israel. Remember, Ma'amad Har Sinai. And this is Har HaMoriah. So the name that he calls the place is Yireh. Now, B'siyata Dishmaya, we're going to Malki Tzedek. We're going to Malki Tzedek, which is Hashem Ben Noach. And you know, even in chapter 110 in Tehillim, we see Malki Tzedek over there. Malki Tzedek, you remember, B'siyata Parashat Lech Lecha, Avraham Avinu and Lot are going together. Both of them have a lot of sheep, a lot of animals, and they can't be together because the shepherds of both sides, they are fighting, because these are the shepherds of Lot don't care if the animals are stealing from fields that don't belong to them, and the shepherds of Avraham Avinu, they care about it, because this is one of the laws that Hashem asked, not to steal from each other. So B'siyata Dishmaya, we see that they separated. Lot goes to live in Sodom and Amorah, which Hashem eliminated. You know where was the place of Sodom and Amorah? Where the Yam HaMelech. with the ocean, the salt, the salty ocean, is that was the place. So dear ladies, b'siyata d'ishmaya, we see that the enemies that come and fight with a place where Lot is in Sodom and Gomorrah, and they take Lot as a prisoner, and Avraham Avinu goes and fights all of these kings, and he wins. And after he wins, when he comes back, we see that Malkitzedek, Malkitzedek Melech Shalem, the king of Shalem, hotzi lechem v'yayin, he takes bread and wine, behu kohen lekel elyon, and he is a high priest of Hashem. וכהן לקדוש ברוך הוא. ויברכהו ויאמר, and he blesses Abraham. ברוך אברהם לכל עליון. Blessed is Abraham to Hashem. קונה שמיים וארץ, that took for himself heaven and earth. וברוך כל עליון, and then he says, pay attention, this is, וברוך כל עליון, and blessed is Hashem, אשר מגן, I forgot here the race, אשר מגן, צריך בידיך, blessed is Hashem that gave all of your enemies in your hands, ויתן לו מעשר מהכל. Then he gives a tenth of everything. Why? Because at the beginning, מלכיצדק was a priest. Now Abraham became a priest. How come? It's the clue. How come Abraham became, just because Malkitzedek, instead of blessing first Hashem, he blessed first Avraham Avinu. You see, Baruch Avraham Lekel Elyon, blesses Avraham for Hashem, and then Ubaruch Kel Elyon. So Hashem took the kohuna, the priesthood from Malkitzedek, and gave it to Avraham Avinu. As he gave him tenth of everything. Why? We had lessons about this. Why did he give him bread and wine? Because he made the fixing of the first human being, Avraham. So he gave him to give a hint that he's making the fixing of the sin of eating from the tree of knowledge, good and bad. I won't go to it because we had shurim about it. We're going to speak about Yerushalayim, how all of this is connected to Yerushalayim. B'siyata d'ishmaya. So let's see, Be'ezrat Hashem. So we see Malkitzedek, Melech Shalem. Malkitzedek is Shem, the son of Noach. Abraham Avinu calls the place Hashem Yireh. He calls the place, what place? Yerushalayim. This place is Yerushalayim because where Yitzchak was sacrificed, he was sacrificed in Yerushalayim, on the mountain of Moriah. So this is the place, B'siyata d'ishmaya, which the Har HaBayit is over there. So B'siyata d'ishmaya, Avraham Avinu, Avraham calls it Yira'e. Malkitzedek, he is the king of Shalem. So B'siyata d'ishmaya, the city of Jerusalem was supposed to be called Yira'e Shalem. And look what Bereshit Rabbah says about it. Bereshit Rabbah, it says, Avraham kara oto yir'e, Shem kara oto Malkitzedek, which is Shem, kara oto Shalem. So Avraham called it yir'e, Malkitzedek called it Shalem, the king of Shalem. Amar HaKadosh Baruch Hu, im ani kora oto yir'e, or if I will call it yir'e, Malkitzedek will be hurt, if I will, because he's righteous, and Hashem loves the righteous people, and he doesn't want to hurt them. He says, if I'll call it Shalem, Avraham Avinu, that is making the fixing for the first human being, for the sin that all of the worlds came down because of it, will also feel hurt. So what shall I do, Omer Hashem? V'im ani kora oto Shalem, Avraham, Adam tzadik mitra'em. Ela hareini kora oto Yerushalem. כמו שקראו שניהם, יראה ושלם. So Hashem said, I'm going to call it ירושלם. רגע, רגע, wait. First of all, how come, what happened that he changed the vav? And where's the yud? There's supposed to be yud here. Wait, we'll come to it. Okay, first of all, let's go now to Yaakov Avinu. So we're going to Yaakov Avinu, and it's written over there, Yaakov Avinu, you remember, took the blessings. Esav said he's going to kill him. He runs away. His father tells him, you have to go and find a wife. Go back to Aram, to your uncle Laban, and over there you'll find your wife. Look how beautiful everything comes in. Okay, so he goes. Meanwhile, he's tired. He's going to sleep b'siyata d'shmeya b'diuk in Yerushalayim, where the Beit HaMikdash is supposed to be. So ba'ifka b'makom. Ba'ifka b'makom means he was davening. He was praying. Ba'ifka b'makom. Ba'ikach me'avnei ha'makom. He's taking from the stones of the place. Sefer HaYetzirah, that is considered that Avraham Avinu wrote. Stones means letters. Look. Ve'ikach me'avnei ha'makom. Ve'yasem me'rashotav. And he took them, put them together under his head in order to sleep. What did he do? Tiru kama ze yafe. Look how beautiful the Torah of Hashem is. Look how we need to appreciate that we are the children of Israel. So what did he really do? He took the stones of the place. He saw Yir'ah. He saw the Aleph and the Hay. These are the stones of the place. And he said, there's three letters in the word Shalem. Okay, in a minute I'll explain why he did this. Three letters, B'siyata D'shmeya, of the word Shalem, nachon, three letters, Shalosh Otiyot. And here there's four letters, Arba Otiyot. What is Yir'ah? Yir'ah is fear, is judgment. Yir'ah, in numerical value, Yir'ah equals Gvurah, which means judgment. It's the left side. Yir'ah, Yud is 10, Resh is 200, Aleph is 1, He is 5. Together, B'siyata, it's 216. Nachon? Gvura, Gimel is 3, Bet is 2, Vav is 6, Resh is 200, He is 5, B'siyata is 216. So this is judgment. So he said, if the letters of judgment are more than the letters of mercy, because this is chesed, and we'll speak in a minute. Why is this chesed, shalem? Kmo shalom, rakabav chaser. It's like peace. Shalem, nachon? Igiya shalem, b'siyata d'shmeya. Yaakov Avinu came shalem after he went from out from Laban and came back to Eretz Israel, to Eretz Kanan b'zat, and he came shalem b'siyata d'shmeya, nachon? You remember? Shabtai levana ma'adim. We learned this on Chanukah. You remember Shabtai? This is Shalem, which means he, Shabtai, Levana, the three stars, v'ma'adim. Three stars, v'siyata d'shmeya, that he came with his money, with his Torah, with his mitzvot, filled, even though he was with Lavan for 22 years. So v'siyata d'shmeya, this is Shalem. So we learn this on Chanukah. I don't want to go in the other things, because I want to concentrate on Yerushalayim. Okay? So this is the clue, Shalem. So we look, Shin is 300. It's like peace, without the Vav. Lamed, כלומר, זה קליקות חסר. Lamed is 30, and Mem is 40. This equals Shin Ayin. It's 370. Shin Ayin, Ayin is 70, Shin is 300. First of all, Shin means the three fathers. Abraham, Yitzchak, ve'Yaakov. Three fathers. I'll give you another thing, beautiful thing. Look how we are waiting for Moshe Rabbeinu, because he's going to Bezrat Hashem. He gave us the Torah. Hashem through him gave the Torah to the children of Israel. Zichru Torat Moshe Avdi. So Moshe, look, Moshe Rabbeinu. Okay, we have the Shin of the three fathers that helped Moshe. What is left? The Mem and the Hay. Mem and the Hay equals Adam. You see, you remember he equals 10, he equals a minyan. Because Mem is 40, He is 5, is 45, Adam 1, Dalet is 4, Mem is 40, 45. And Moshe Rabbeinu was a chariot for Hashem. And what does the chariot of Hashem has? It has the Nesher, it has the eagle. The chariot of Hashem has the Nesher, it has the Aryeh, and it has the Shor, which means the eagle, the lion, and the ox, and Adam. These three are the Shin, and Adam is this, the Mem Hei. So he's a full chariot of Hashem. Mamash is the full chariot of Hashem. So let's continue. So we see this equals Shin Ayin. Shin Ayin, B'siyata Dishma Darizal says, these are 370 lights that come from the heaven of mercy. Why? Because it's written in the Tehillim Chesed, Kel Kol Hayom. The mercy of Hashem, Kel, is the whole day. Now look how beautiful. Kel, twice Kel. Eli, Eli, lama azavtani. Twice Kel. Let's open the Kel. This is an Aleph. So we write Aleph, Lamed, the Pei. Aleph is 1, Lamed is 30. Okay, I'm opening. The Kuf is an Aleph. I can't write it over here. And the Pei is 80. Together it's 1, 1, 1. Okay, and then we have Lamed. Lamed. Lamed is 30. Mem is 40. Daled is 4. Together it's 74. 74 plus 111, it's 180. 185 multiplied by 2, kize Eli Eli lama zavtani 2, twice is 370. Which means Shalem is all lights of Chesed. So let's see what happened. Besiyata Dishmaya, as at the beginning there was a big question. Hashem had a big question. Will he call Yerushalayim Shalem Yireh? Which means, either he will call Yerushalayim, this is Yireh Shalem, Yerushalayim, or he will start with Shalem, Shalem ve'Yireh. Which means he will start with Chesed and finish with Din, with judgment. But the name of Yerushalayim is not, the name of today is only, it starts with judgment and ends with Chesed, nachon? Why? Because he said that if we'll start with a mercy and then chas v'shalom we will won't listen to Hashem and do the opposite of what Hashem wants us to do, then when judgment comes, there's nothing to soften judgment. There's nothing over here to soften. It's the end of the name. So it's better it starts with judgment and then there's mercy at the end in order to soften the judgment. That's how powerful the names are. That's how it's powerful even when you call a name to your babies. Because the names are the source of livelihood of the children and each and every one of us. That's why it's important that we call ourselves the whole name and not shorten the name. It's very, because this is the source of light that comes upon us. And we've studied this also. We spoke about the letters. So let's continue. So we see now there was a big debate. And we see it was decided that it will start with judgment, the name, and will end with Chesed. So we see that Yaakov Avinu, what did he do? He said there are 4 letters of judgment and only 3 letters of Chesed. It has to be equal. Because otherwise it's not equal, and the judgment has more power than the mercy, the Chesed. So he took the stones, Vaif Gaba Makom, he was davening to Hashem, please Hashem, have mercy upon my children. I know that there's going to be a ruining of the temple, and have mercy on them. These 2 letters has to be 1. Aleph is 1 in numerical value. Hey is 5. Together it's 6, which is the Vav. This is the Vav. Instead of Aleph and Hey, he took 6. Because Aleph is 1, Hey is 5, together it's 6. 6 in numerical value is the letter Vav. Why Yaakov Avinu is the one that did this? Because Yaakov Avinu was Ish Tam Yoshev Alim, a very honest person who is sitting between the tents of Abraham Avinu and the tent of Yitzchak Avinu. So this is an Aleph. This is the Vav is Yaakov. And the Yud of Chesed on the right side, this is Yemin, this is Abraham. Abraham. And the Yud that is over here, down, this is the Din, it's Yitzchak, because it's on the left side, and this is Judgment. Ze Chesed, Veze Smol. You see, it's Judgment. And who is in the middle, Yaakov? Why? Because Yaakov is Tiferet, is glory. Tiferet. And Tiferet is parallel to the Torah. And he had 12 tribes that studied the Torah, and from them all of the children of Israel came. So he's the Vav, so he davened, he took the stones which are parallel to letters by Avraham Avinu in the book of Yetzirah, the book of creation, and he said, this is the Siyata Lishmaya Avav. So now there's one, two, three letters of judgment. You see, there's three letters, Shalosh Otiyot, and there's also three letters of Chesed. Three letters. Okay, it's equal now. But we are missing a Yud. Eliyahu Navi gave a Yud to Yerushalayim. Oh. This is Eliyahu Navi. Gave the Yud to Yerushalayim. So, lo shalem, ela Yerushalayim. With a Yud. Yud comes from Yud Kei Vav Kei, Besiyata Dishmaya. Yud comes from the name Besiyata Dishmaya, that Eliyahu, because what is Eliyahu? Look. Eliyahu is, when he will come and announce Mashiach Be'ezrat Hashem, we know that he's, yeah, why sure. Do we know that he's going to announce it? We just had Parashat Pinchas, Eliyahu Arba, that Eliyahu Navi includes Pinchas, includes Nadav Ve'Avihu, and we also had lessons about it. So B'Siyata Dishmaya, why? Because he has Hei Vav and Aleph. Ki Yad Al Kesiyah Milchama La'Hashem Midor Dor. The end of Parashat B'Shalach, after there's, after Amalek comes and takes all of the people that are in the back, Ameasef, in the back of the children of Israel, that they are very tired and they are in the back, which means tired spiritually. And he takes them and he cuts their circumcision and he throws it to the sky and he says, Hashem, take yours. Hashem said, I'm going to eliminate Amalek. So when Amalek is eliminated, the Aleph of the Kiseh, Kiseh is missing an Aleph. The throne of Hashem is missing the letter Aleph, Alufo Shel Olam. And then the name of Hashem is Yud-Kei. It's not full. But when Eliyahu Nevi comes and announces and Mashiach is here, the name of Hashem will have again Vav-Kuf. And all of the completing letters are inside the name of Eliyahu. And what is left? Li. Li. What is Li? Vayitem Li Segula Mikol Amim. It's the oath that Hashem gave that we are going to be the special nation, his firstborn from all of the nations forever. Look how Hashem loves us. So B'Siyata Dishmaya, we have the Yud over here. But then we see sometimes that Yerushalayim is written inside the books of Torah without a Vav and without a Yud sometimes. And why? Yes. And why? Why this happens? So it says like this. Rabbi Shimshon Moslopolia says like this. הוא כותב כך, וזכרתי את בריתי יעקב בחמישה מקומות נכתב יעקב מלא. There are five places in the Torah that Hashem wrote, gave Moshe Rabbeinu to write the name of Yaakov with a Vav. Five places that Hashem wrote Eliyahu without a Vav, yeah. With a missing Vav. Mm-hmm. Why did Yaakov take the Vav from Eliyahu? Because Yaakov said, I'm taking it until you come and announce to my children that this is the time of Mashiach. That Mashiach is coming. So I'm taking the Vav. Once B'Siyata Dishmaya you come, you get back the Vav. Once you announce, it's like I'm holding it until you announce it. And then the Vav of Esav will be also taken. And he will be Ash. The Vav of Esav will be also taken, and he will become nothing. That's the promise in the prophecy of Obadiah Navi, Matre Asar, the Obadiah the prophet. So he will come Ash, and the Vav will go back to Eliyahu and Yaakov. Yaakov will take back the Vav, like he took the Yud. Because you remember Esav, when he was born, he was a full human being. He had a lot of hair. So they wanted to call him Asui, which means made, Asui. We also studied this. Where can I write it? Over here. Asui. With a Yod. But Yaakov, ready already. Yeah. So, but Yaakov held his heel in order to take the Yud. Wow. and he was holding his heel, so he was supposed to be called heel, Akev. אנחנו עקבת דמשיחה. We are in this time, ממש. So once he held him, he took the yud, and it became Yaakov.
Look how beautiful it is.
So he took the yud and it became Yaakov. So what's happening with Siyat HaLishma? כתוב כך, it's written by Yechezkel, המלאך החרבה, which means that the city of Yerushalayim was ruined, why לא נתמלא צור, אלא מחורבנה של ירושלים. The city of Tzur didn't fill with a vav. The name was not filled with a vav, only because the children of Israel with our deeds caused the ruining of the temple, and because of that, the vav of Yerushalayim went to Tzur. Can you understand what we are doing? The vav of Yerushalayim went to Tzur. Furthermore,
went to what?
Tzur, it's a city. It's a city of, so, and it's written, I'll give you from Yechezkel. Lesiyata Lishmaya. Yechezkel Chavav. I'm going to open and read you from Yechezkel. Lesiyata Lishmaya, look. Emalai Achareva, which means, for she was destroyed. Lachen ko amar Hashem Elokim. That's why Hashem, God, He said, "Hineni alaych tzor. I am going to go to you tzor. I'm going to go against you tzor. Ve'eleti alaych goyim, and I'm going to ruin you. You ruined Yerushalayim. I'm going to ruin you." He says, "Ve'eleti alaych goyim rabim ka'alot hayam agala." It's like an ocean with waves. This is how Hashem is going to go at Besiyata Dishmaya and put down the city of tzor. And he will ruin all of our walls and everything, and will wake, and everything will come, become dust of the city of Tzor. But we know that also Rome, by the Romans came and ruined the second temple. Nachon? And we know that a lot of the tools of Beit HaMikdash are in Rome, in the Vatican.
Yeah.
So look what's going to happen at the end of days. Siyata Lishmaya. I don't want to wipe the board. I'll have to do it. I have to find a place. Okay.
Rabbanit.
Sige, את חלה לצלם את זה רגע?
מה?
ואז אני מחל? Okay, can I wipe?
I have a שנייה.
This is a very important board. Baruch Hashem, it's Hashem, Mama. This is what we are doing. This is the fixing. And there's not really, there's not truly in heaven. There's not letters. There's lights. But once they come to this world, it becomes like letters. Just like we have rain. Rain in heaven is called matar. When it comes to this world, it calls geshem. Mm-hmm. It becomes gashmi, it becomes physical. It's the two words for rain in Hebrew, but one of them is spiritual, like the levana in yareach, the moon. In a spiritual place, it's called levana. But when it comes to this world, we call it moon, yareach. So it's two different, it's a different levels of spirituality. One is physical and one is spiritual. That's why Rabbi Mordechai Sharabi said that they never came to the Levana. Everybody says they came to they went to the moon there, but they never got to the Levana. You understand? This is everything that came to this world becomes physical. The more it goes down through the walls, because we are in the physical world over here. So let's continue Bezrat Hashem. So let's see. So Rome, why do we see sometimes without a yud? Nachon? We see without a yud, we see Yerushalayim written mamash in the books, in the book of Torah, Batanach, without a yud sometimes. Yerushalayim it's written. Mm-hmm. Where is the yud? The same thing, Besiyata Lishma, I'm going to write it over here. The same thing, Banot Yekarot. It's without a yud because Romi took it. Rome took the yud. Mm. It went to Romi. How do we know this? In Yerushalayim, now I'm going to write בסייעתא דשמיא, I'm taking שלי, you see שין למד יוד, you see it over here? And then, what's left of it is רומי. ריש, וו, מם, this is the מם, ויוד, רומי, שלי רומי, ירושלים. בשיא שלי רומי, look how beautiful Hashem. This means at the end of days, everything that Rome took from us is going to back to be us, ours again. מה זה שלי? שין is 300, מם is, למד is 30, and יוד is 10, it's 340. 340 is שומר דלתות ישראל. Wow. Is the name of Hashem, שומר דלתות ישראל, the name Shaddai, the name that Hashem used in order to tell the world, stop, you cannot widen anymore. At the beginning, when the world was created, and we had lessons about this, so when the world was created, all of the water, the ocean, the skies, widened all the time. And Hashem said, die, stop. With the name, B'siyata Dishmaya, Shomer Daltot Yisrael, he who keeps safe the children of Israel. And then this is, Shin is 300. We have, Daled is 4, and Yud is 10. It's 314. And this is 340. Plus the name Yud Kei Vav Kei, 26, is 340. So at the end of days, B'siyata Dishmaya, all of the, what Rome took from us, that is now in the Vatican, is going to come back, Be'ezrat Hashem, to the children of Israel, to put it back in the Amen. Temple that will be built, B'mira B'yaminu Amin. So now we spoke about the name. Now let's go, אני הולכת איתכם בית הזוהר הקדוש מעם מועז, אני אלך איתכם בסייעתא דשמיא. I'll read from you from also from the Zohar Chadash, but a little bit. There are seven כתוב, ויקרא אלוקים לרקיע שמיים, ויהי ערב ויהי בוקר יום שני. That Hashem is calling בסייעתא דשמיא. For God, I can't see without this. Hashem, firmament, it's called רקיע? Firmament. I never remember how to say it. So it, Hashem is calling the firmament. B'siyata Dishmaya, heaven. Now there are seven firmaments. One of them, the first one is called Vilon. And the one that is called Vilon, Shehu Hazach Beyoter Ve'al Yado Mo'ar HaOlam. From this, this first one, this first heaven, I would call it Rakia. Everybody understands that I'm talking about the firmament. So this is called Vilon, and from here there's light in this world. B'siyata Dishmaya, Shehu Zach Beyoter, that very clean light that comes to this world, that gives us the day and night. The second one is called Rakia. Shebo Tluim HaShemesh, and in this one, the second one, the moon, the stars, the sun, everything is in that, the second one. The third Rakia is called Shchakim. Shebahem Machinim Et Haman Bishvil HaTzadikim. Over there, Hashem sees that the man is the food that the children of Israel ate in the desert for 40 years, that they didn't have any waste, because it's the food of the angels. So over there, in the third Rakia, they prepare this food, B'siyata Dishmaya, for the Tzadikim Ba'olam, for the righteous in the world. It says, "Machinim et haman bishvil hatzadikim ba'olam haba." All of this for the righteous people in heaven, in Gan Eden, in paradise. Umisham ba'im rachamim bizman saratam, and from there comes the mercy upon us when we have trouble over here, benoshaim, and we are saved. The fourth one is called Zvul, and we had a whole lesson about the fourth one, between the sun and the moon. We need to search it in Torah any time and just find the lesson and put it. Remember, from this we learned how we should behave in this world, B'siyata Dishmaya, and not answer back, and be nice, Be'ezrat Hashem, from the moon and the sun. at this fourth one שבו בנויה ירושלים. ירושלים, Jerusalem in heaven is in the fourth heaven. שבו בנויה ירושלים של מעלה ובית המקדש. And the third temple is in this heaven, in the fourth heaven. שהוא מכוון כנגד זה שלמטה, that it's parallel to the one that is over here in this world. ושם מזבח, and there's an altar over there. שהמלאך הגדול ביותר ששמו מיכאל, and the biggest angel that is called מיכאל, שהוא שרו של ישראל, that he is the minister of the children of Israel, מקבל את נשמת הצדיק, that receives the soul of a righteous person that comes out of this world. When we pass away, if we are righteous, היוצא מן העולם הזה, והוא מביאו לקורבן על המזבח הזה. And he puts him as a sacrifice on this altar. And the fifth one is called Ma'on. And over there, ברבבות מלאכים שאומרים שירה לפני הקדוש ברוך הוא. And there's 10,000 of angels, a lot of angels that say a song in front of Hashem in the fifth one. כל לילה, every night, ושותקים כשמאיר היום. And they are silent when the day comes בשביל ישראל, for the children of Israel. תבין, ועשר משמרות של מלאכים יש ברקיע, המתחלקים לשלוש כיתות, and there are 10 gods that always change of angels over there. And they are separated to 3 classes. וכל אחת מהן אומרת שירה בזמנה, and each one of them says a song in front of Hashem. Each one it's on its own time. ובשעת הבוקר, and in the morning, כל הכוכבים והמזלות והמלאכים, all of the stars, all of the constellations, and all of the angels say a song in front of Hashem. כל אחד לפי גודלו, each one by its worth in front of Hashem. וכשמאיר היום, מתחילים השירה, השמיים לומר שירה, and when light comes, heavens start with זה פרק שירה, heavens start saying a song in front of Hashem. ושלוש כיתות של מלאכים אומרים שירה, האחת אומרת, and three crosses of angels say a song in front of Hashem. The first one says kadosh, sanctifies, which means holy. The second one says kadosh kadosh, holy holy. And the third one says kadosh 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 Hashem Tzvot. Holy, holy, holy is the name of Hashem, Hashem Tzvaot, Hashem, the Lord. So pay attention. Omer al zeh Rabbi, Omer al zeh Me'am Loez. He says Me'am Loez, Ad kama, just look Ad kama yekarim Yisrael lifnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Look how the children of Israel are so precious in front of Hashem, even more than the angels. כי ישראל אומרים שירה בכל שעה. The children of Israel can say a song every hour, every minute of the day to speak to Hashem. ואילו המלאכים אינם יכולים. The angels cannot do that. We can do that. We can praise the name of Hashem every minute of the day, every second of the day. We can daven to Hashem by the Torah, תפילה דאורייתא, speak to him, Hashem, please. בסייעתא דשמיא. ואל שדאי שאמר לעולם די אומר דה לצרותינו אמן כן יהי רצון. And the angel cannot do this. He says ואילו המלאכים אינם יכולים לומר אלא פעם אחת ביום. They can say only one time a day. ויש שאינם אומרים אלא פעם אחת בשבוע. And some of them cannot say even once a day, only once a week. And the ones that can say only once a month. And there are ones that can say only once a year from the angels. And there are ones that can say only once in 7 years. And there are ones that can say only one in 50 years, Yovel. ויש שאומרים, אלא רק פעם אחת בעולם. And there are ones that created only to say once in the whole time of the world. And the children of Israel can say every minute of the day. ועוד מעלה אחת יש ישראל. And furthermore, there's another merit to the children of Israel. כי הם מזכירים את שם השם אחרי שתי תיבות. They mention the name of Hashem after two words. They say Shema Yisrael Hashem. Two words. Shema is one, Israel two, and Hashem is three. After two words, they say the name of Hashem. But the angels know. They say Kadosh, 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 Holy, 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 and then they mention the name of Hashem. And then V'siyata Dishmaya. And it says, Ve'ein reshut la'malachim lomar shira le'malah. And the angels are not allowed to say a song in front of Hashem in heaven. Lifnei she'Yisrael omrim shira le'mata. Before we say the praise of Hashem. Do you understand? Because we had lessons about this, because we are the shliach tzibur of the whole world. There are 22 tubes of prosperity that comes to this world, parallel to the 22 Hebrew Aleph Bet, the 22 letters of Sfat HaKodesh, of the holy language, the Hebrew. 22. Only when we start praying to Hashem, we open the tubes for everyone. Then the animals start saying a song in front of Hashem, the ocean, the sun, the moon, everybody starts saying, because we open the tubes of prosperity to the whole world. And the angels wait for us to start in order that they can sing in front of Hashem. So, Me'am Lo'es says, Pesiyat HaDishmei, Eskotot Egen Aleinu, he says, Kacha. בכל זה סימן, כי ישראל הם חביבים יותר מן המלאכים. And all this shows us that the children of Israel, that are the firstborns of Hashem, Hashem loves them more than anything in the world. לכן צריך אדם להתראות בפני Hashem, a person should have the fear, יראה, ירושלים, the fear of Hashem. שאם הוא עובר עבירה, if he makes a sin, he doesn't listen to Hashem, בסייעתא דשמיא, he causes destruction in all of the worlds, in all of the universe. So we need now that we are in בין המצרים, in between the 17th of Tammuz and תשעה באב, the 9th of Tammuz, of Av, בסייעתא דשמיא, we need to think about what we are doing. We need to remember how precious Yerushalayim is for us. We need Besiyata Dishmaya to remember that already the third temple is coming towards earth. The soldiers of Hashem are all over the world. All of the soldiers of Hashem, also the soldiers of the Samech Mem from the other side, we can see what does Hashem want. He wants the children of Israel to keep his commandments, to be happy and to make other people happy, to do good deeds. He wants the nations to keep the commandments, the seven commandments of Noah. He wants the nations to also to do good deeds. This will bring Mashiach 1, 2, 3. So our deed now is to keep Yerushalayim as a home. That the Siyata Dishmaya will remember the essence of Yerushalayim. We'll remember B'siyata Dishmaya that this is the capital, it's going to be the capital of the whole world. And when B'Mashiach is here, Yerushalayim will be filled with precious stones. Light will come from all over, and the light of the Hashem, of infinity, will be all over. And all of us, the children of Israel, and all of the nations will come to bring sacrifice in the temple, B'siyata Dishmaya, that will come from heaven to this world and will put the gates, B'siyata Dishmaya. I would like to remind you, B'ezrat Hashem, that this Shabbat is Shabbat and Rosh Chodesh, and always I remind you, B'siyata Dishmaya, the name that we need, the right combination of the name of Hashem, Yud Kei Vav Kei and Eyeh Asher Yeh, for the month that is coming. On Shabbat, when we say Musaf of Shabbat and Rosh Chodesh, we mention B'siyata Dishmaya, we just visualize the name of Hashem. It comes from the Pasuk in Parashat Kitavo, Hasketu Shema Yisrael Hayom, which means be silent, the children of Israel, and listen today. That's what I'm saying. Listen today. See how precious the children of Israel and Yerushalayim and Beit HaMikdash is for Hashem. So B'siyata Dishmaya, the name of Hashem is from the initials of the words. The name is Kuf. You remember that this is a Hey, the letter Hey, the letter Vav, the letter Yud, and the letter Hey. And then we have from the name of repentance of Hashem, the letter Hey, the letter Yud, and then the letter Aleph, and then the letter Hey. בסייעתא דשמיא מהשם, bless all of us that we will all be זוכה to be משיח צדקנו ורחמים גמורים במהרה בימינו, אמן. אליהו הנביא זכור לטוב, ללא מפרד אדם לחברו בדבר הלכה, יחיד ברבים הלכה כרבים. תלינו בטוב ותקיצו בישועה ורחמים. You sleep well בעזרת השם, and you'll wake up with salvation.
אמן.